Hello, Libra. Welcome to another Incoming Love series, and this is going to be for your September 2019. For this reading, we will look at the energies that are coming towards you in terms of incoming love. So incoming love could either be a new love that you will be meeting, and or somebody possibly returning from the past, or somebody you have dealt with in the past, and now they are coming in forward towards you and representing as an incoming love, incoming new opportunity for you. So you take it however that resonates. I'm just going to be reading the cards for you for September of 2019. All right? So let's see what's coming towards Libra. Incoming love for Libra in September of 2019. By the way, to all my subscribers, thank you for stopping by once again. If you need information with regards to my private readings, the tarot decks that I'm using, as well as if ever I would extend this video, the link and other information will be in the description box below. So check them out. All right? All right, Libra. Here we go. This is for Libra, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. In love. Incoming love for Libra for September of 2019. Libra, you have the King of Pentacles. You have the Empress. You have the Five of Wands. The Magician. Four of Wands. The Hangman. The Queen of Swords. Wow. Nine of Cups. The World. All right. At the bottom of the deck, we have the Ten of Pentacles. Okay. All right, Libra. I'm getting here that the person who you would be possibly meeting or possibly coming towards you as an incoming love is someone who is a stable person, stable in a sense of like financially stable, have all their investments in place, somebody who has worked hard in life and have possibly collected enough amount of stability. Materials that, I mean, enough things that they need in their day-to-day life, the basic needs, money, food, shelter, clothing, and all that, as well as this person, I feel that has the capability of investing something that could last in a long term, somebody who is stable. Literally, for some of you, I feel that this person is possibly mature in age as compared to you, so this could possibly be a person who is a little bit older. All right, and yeah, energies wise, I feel that this person is someone who when you meet this person, you would see that they are more into stability, working hard, working smart, so that in the long term you reap your rewards. And I feel that this person is possibly have done that already, so they're pretty stable. Okay, and for some of you Libra men, this person could actually be, if you're meeting a Libra woman, I feel that this woman is, you know, in their fertile time. So possibly this person is someone who's wanting to have kids when you meet them. Or for some of you, you could even meet this person in the hospital when you're doing your checkup, your, you know, like the yearly executive checkup that you do. And possibly you will meet this person there, yeah. But in general, this person is, when you meet them, you would see that they don't have, this person wouldn't, you wouldn't feel that this person is a player kind of person. They are more the serious type this time around. Somebody who, you know, probably in the right age of, or at the right time in their life, that they want to have commitment. They want to have a no longer playing the field, so to speak. Yeah, or possibly, yeah, somebody who is already stable, ready to meet a new person that they want to be with, in a rather more serious note rather than just playing the field. You know, I feel that you will also be meeting this person possibly in some celebrations. It could be like a wedding celebrations or baby showers. Yeah. And yeah. And you'll find this person very attractive. Very beautiful, very handsome, pleasant to the eyes. Which I think that is one thing that, you know, for a Libra, that actually is one of the first things that you would always notice. Okay? Although, internally, I feel that this person, even if they show, or this person shows a level of like maturity, a level of stability in where they are at right now in life, there's that sense of conflicted mindset in this person's life. It feels like there are some things in their life that perhaps they haven't really gotten resolved. Say, you know, childhood traumas, for instance, that may have caused them to have this conflict as they start to connect with other people. There's that fear of, let's say, intimacy, fear of being close to someone. So although you see them as a very, like, a stable, grounded person, someone who's wanting to be a companion perhaps, but as you get to know this person, there's that bit of conflicted mindset. You get to know that, you'll get to realize it, you'll get to see that as you start connecting. Yeah, but nevertheless, once you start connecting, you'd see that there are a lot of things in this connection that you can do together. There's a lot of things that you can create. It's possible that you may even be building or creating new business together, business ventures. It could also be like, you know, you could also have this fixer-upper kind of business, I feel, with this person. Anything that could generate income, I feel that you would literally click with this person in terms of creativity, business-minded kind of person that you can be dealing with. Okay. The challenge I see for this connection is somehow, even though you know that this could be a person that you can be with, Libra, you'll easily get that feeling, that comfort level with this person, right? And although you do have this feeling that this could be the right person for you, there's that bit of instability in terms of really being committed. It's funny because when I see the King of Pentacles, I feel that that is the person who would love to nurture a relationship. Perhaps that would be something that they would show you when you first meet them. But as you continue to get together, get to know each other, you realize that at some point this person is a little bit conflicted inside. Somehow there's that part of them that they don't know. What do they really want? I feel that this is just like a first impression, but the reality of things is there's a lot of confusion in this person's mind that could possibly lead to instability in terms of having a commitment in this connection. But when you get to know, when you start hanging out, you see that this person is very engaging. This person is wanting to kind of create new things with you, go with you in different endeavors and things like that, even earn money, earn more income, passive or active income together. You'll see that happening, but there is that bit of, there's that side of them that is conflicted, and that would cause a little bit of instability as you, for this connection, as you go, as you get to know each other, okay? And there's going to be a lot of waiting game, again, because you feel that this person is kind of wanting to, like, be with you and things like that, but with conflicted mindset, Libra, at some point you would want to move forward with this person, but it feels like they're not, there's that reason or there's that reasoning in them that they're not always ready, and you'll always be hanging yourself upside down, waiting, contemplating, trying to see and understand their point of view, their own perspective, and trying to see things from their angle. Yeah, so there's going to be that waiting game for you. But Libra, here you are, Queen of Swords. Regardless, I feel that there's also be that level of mind games perhaps with this person. But Libra, for this connection, you're sharp. So you would know, you would take time and give time for this person to show you how credible they are, how trustworthy they can be in a connection. You will give that, you will give them time. You will contemplate, you will see things from their side. But I feel that as time goes on, and I think there's going to be that point where after all this, you will be the Libra that you are. That at some point, you know how to, where to draw the line, where to speak up, when to speak up, and try to hear them out. If you feel that they are telling the truth, if their explanation and reasoning is something that is justifiable for you, then you'll take it. Otherwise, I feel that you may not, you'll just cut this person out of your life. But you will give them time. So I feel that once you meet this person, I feel that you would be willing to give some time to get to know them and see how trustworthy they are, if they are... if they function with integrity, if they are trustworthy, if they are dependable, reliable type of person. Because the first time you meet them, you would see that side of them, that they want stability, they're grounded, they're intelligent even, they're a good investor of their time, effort, money, and things like that. And it feels like they're wanting to grow and expand with you. You would have that feeling when you first meet them. But underlying it all, there is that level of being conflicted deep inside that would cause some form of instability within this connection. You're being advised here, Libra, that regardless, you know, when you meet this person, always stand from your corner in this connection, right? Stand your ground and know that whatever makes you happy, whether it be with this connection or just be on your own, stand by it. Because this connection should serve as an enhancement or as an addition to your life rather than giving you additional worries. Because you have this, Libra. With or without this connection, you are already at a point in your life where you have the Nine of Cups, your wish fulfillment, you are there. I feel that you are already, Libra, at a point in your life where you are stable. You have somehow everything that you possibly need and, well, partly want in life, right? So you are in the state where you've got your wish fulfillment, even with yourself. So when you get to know this person, don't be bogged down by their being conflicted. If they have mind games, stay away from those. If they want to play that, let them, but know when to pull the trigger, know when to bring in your Queen of Swords energy. But I feel it's worth getting to know this person, all right? The general advice here is, Libra, whatever you've had in the past, in your previous relationships, perhaps they may have failed, they may have been successful, and then you ultimately moved on. Learn from the experiences in the past and make sure that in this new connection, things that didn't work in the past, leave it behind and improve in this new connection to make this connection worthwhile, you know. The underlying energy here is there's that opportunity for this connection to be your ultimate happiness. This could even turn out into marriage if things are if things can go well between the two of you. If you can sort out working, if you can both work things out despite the conflicted sort of energy from this person, if waiting and contemplation turns out to be, well, a good method in getting to know each other all the more, yeah. But nevertheless, there is this opportunity for this connection to last a long term. Here we have the Five of Pentacles. I feel that either you or this person coming towards you is someone who possibly have been feeling down lately. It could also be, all right, so likely so, with this world and the Five of Pentacles here, I feel that for some of you, this could be a person that you may have dealt with in the past, somebody that, things didn't work, and then you probably split and went your own ways. And then now they're coming back and seeing if you can both reconnect. So that can also be a possibility. So take it however that resonates on your side. But in general, this is the type of energy that I see coming towards you for the month of September. I'm going to be extending this reading, Libra. So if you're interested, I will clarify all these cards, whether it be truly a fresh new person in your life or a returning person. Let's see how it goes and how the connection would transpire this time around. If you're interested, the link will be in the description box below. If this is where we part ways, thank you for stopping by. And don't forget to hit like, subscribe, as well as click on the notification bell. Bye now, guys.